Kim Show.
Well, as you can see, I love watching Cooking with Tittle, and I'm so glad you love watching too, because we've got a new email address. That's right. It's tittleinthemiddle@live.com. So I do hope you will email your Tittle. I've got some great green things going on for this year and some healthy treats. Bon appetit, let's eat, each and every Thursday at 7 p.m. and Fridays at 2 p.m. right here on Channel 19. And now, back to the show. Hey. Tittle's in the middle. Wanna have some fun? Some fun? Some fun? Some fun? Some fun? Welcome, welcome, welcome to the LaDonna Tittle TV radio show.
My spin on the Cornish Hen is like the All Stars.
I got beans, greens, potatoes, tomatoes, lamb, ram, hog, dog, chicken, turkey, rat,
you name it!
It's cocktail time, you name it.
Potatoes, tomatoes, lamb, rams, hogs, dogs, chicken, turkeys, rabbits.
You name it! You name it!
Hey, remember when I did my Cornish Hen? Well, I've got a new spin on Cornish Hen. Your Tittle just went crazy, okay? With my stuffed green peppers, my onions, and everything, we're gonna lay this Cornish Hen to rest. I'm gonna jerk it this time with my liquid smoke jerk sauce and my garlic. First, we're gonna stuff the cavity of the Cornish Hen with the jerk sauce, and we're gonna sprinkle the nice garlic chopped up bits, and we're gonna stuff it real good, and we're gonna rub it down with my jerk sauce. Then we're gonna layer it with all the vegetables, the green peppers, the yellow peppers, the orange peppers, the red onions, and the white onions. This is gonna be so juicy. And then we're gonna make sure that cavity is stuffed with all the vegetables. Then we've got our seasonings. Turmeric, yes, a little rosemary, a little pepper, and of course more garlic powder. I wrap it real tight, and we're gonna pop it in the oven at about 375 or 400, because it's gonna cook for about an hour and a half until it's nice and juicy. And we're gonna lay it out and make it look pretty with a little spinach around the bowl, and we can top it off with a little spricket of rosemary. My spin on the Cornish Hen is like the All-Stars of Cornish Hens. It's the best of the best. Onions, if you're not allergic to onions and you like onions, yes, I use the yellow onions stuffed in the Cornish Hens. It's like a natural tenderizer. Organic, you know what I mean? Then I really went crazy. Now, how about Cornish Hen stuffed with proteins, like my 15 bean soup mix? soak your beans overnight. That's right, soak them real good. Then we're going to pop them in the Cornish hen. And we're going to cook this a little bit longer because beans takes a little bit. I would say cook your beans first and then stuff your Cornish hen. Get that span on the hen. How do I love thee? I love thee many different ways. My spin on the Cornish hen. Here's the recipes. Those were good. You talk about protein and a nice Cornish hen that's juicy and tender. This can go a long ways. That's a meal for a whole week. Here's some more good ideas for my Cornish hens. Thank you.
chicken, turkey, rat.
You name it!
Bon appetit, let's eat some clean greens. Tittle's gourmet greens. Thank you. those greens look so good. Bon appetit, let's eat. I think I'll go cook me a pot up today. So glad you're enjoying episode 4 of volume 1, my pictorial audio cookbook soon to be released. Now your Tittle's got something special for you. That's right, some turkey butt soup. Take those turkey tails, boil them as usual, and then just add some onion soup mix. That's it. You boil them for about 3 hours till they're nice and tender and falling off the bone. You can add some more vegetables, and you've got some turkey butt soup. And I tell you, after eating those turkey butts, whether you do jerk or plain, just by adding a little jerk sauce on there, you're going to have a good nap. You know what turkey does for you. It's good and hearty, and it's a good meat. Check it out. Tittle's gone crazy with the turkey tails. Gobble, gobble, gobble. It is so good, so delicious, and very easy to make. Cooking with Tittle, thank you for enjoying Volume 1, Episode 4 of my soon-to-be-released cookbook. You name it, we gonna have it in there.
Potatoes, tomatoes, lamb, rams, hogs, dogs, chicken, turkeys, rabbits, you name it, you name it.
It's cocktail time, you name it. I want to share some of my signature drinks. Bon appetit, let's eat. You're cooking with Tittle. Volume 1, Episode 4 of my soon-to-be-released pictorial audio cookbook.
When I die and I lay me to rest, gonna go to the place that's the best. When I lay me down to die, going up to the spirit in the sky. Going up to the spirit in the sky.
There's nothing like a good cocktail to calm you down, put you to sleep, or even to wake you up. Your Tittle's got her signature cocktails. These are cocktails that I kind of tweaked or made it my own. This one I call my Tittle Russian Assimilator. Oh yeah, it'll get you straight. Ice cubes in a glass, a nice pretty glass, like a fluted glass. This is normally a hurricane glass, but use an ice glass. Gelato vanilla bean, it's like ice cream, but it's Italian cream, gelato. Or you can use almond breeze, it's a non-dairy milk. Or you can use plain cream. 2 shots of Svedka coconut vodka, 2 shots of Kahlua, and float the Kahlua on top once you get all of your mixture in your glass. You can eat it or you can drink it. I prefer to drink it. Here's to you. Here's the recipe. Enjoy Tittle's Russian Assimilator. Tittle's signature cosmopolitan. It's so good and it's so easy to make. While you're chilling one glass, have another big glass chilling, because you will want to. You're going to pour 1 shot of vodka. Make that 2 shots of vodka. And then we're going to have 2 shots of the coconut vodka, Svedka vodka. And then we're going to have our lime. We're going to have our fresh squeezed lime. And we're also going to have our dash of cranberry juice. And instead of the Contro, the secret to a good cosmopolitan is a shot of Grand Marnier. Oh, and of course, 1 sugar cube. You're going to shake that jigger until it's chilling. And then you're going to pour it into your chilled, beautiful glass for your martini cosmopolitan, because that's what a cosmopolitan is, a nice pink martini, or red martini, or cranberry color martini. It's good, and you're gonna love it. Bon appetit, let's drink a good Tittle's signature cosmopolitan. Here's the recipe. Enjoy. For my best girlfriends, my sisters at the microphone, when they're out, they will call me. They'll say, Tittle, tell the bartender how to make our cosmopolitan. And I tell you, I tell them, enjoy that cosmopolitan, the baked beans and all the great greens that we did. There's more to come on Cooking with Tittle, Volume 1, Episode 5. Coming up next time on Cooking with Tittle. Bon appetit, let's eat and drink responsibly.
Rumors spread around, United Texas town. About the shack outside the game. You know what I'm talking about. Just let me know if you're gonna go. Oh my, on the range, they got a lot of nice girls. Amazing.
Just the way we like it. Yay! It's our 30th day of being quarantined, and we're about to go crazy. We'll just do anything. Another day of the global pandemic with coronavirus. Coronavirus is very serious, and haven't been out in about 3 weeks, so supplies were low, especially with fresh vegetables and things that go rapidly. And I gotta stop at the liquor store. Okay. Bon appetit. Let's eat and stay healthy.